Hi everyone, ready to level up your video editing? Today, we're going to dive into Adobe Premiere Pro and create a super catchy, smooth, and elegant text animation. It's simple, but looks fantastic, and I'll walk you through every step. Let's get started. I've already created a sequence and added my background. First, select the Type tool and type out your text. Then, select all the text by pressing Ctrl plus A or Command plus A on Mac. Go over to the Properties panel and adjust the text parameters to your liking. In my case, I'll keep them as default for now and simply make sure it's aligned to the center. Next, head over to the Effects panel and search for the crop effect. Drag and drop it onto your text layer. Do the same for the transform effect. Search for it and drag it onto the text layer as well. Now, go to the Effect Controls panel. Under the transform effect, change the shutter angle to 360. We need to add a couple of position keyframes. I'll move the text slightly down, then click the stopwatch icon next to position to create the first keyframe. Then, move the playhead about 1 second forward and click the reset parameter button next to position. This returns the text to its original placement. For a smoother animation, select both keyframes, right-click on either one, and choose Ease In. Then, right-click again and choose Ease Out. Now, expand the position property. In the graph editor, drag the right side handle toward the left and the left side handle way up. This creates a dynamic movement that starts quickly and decelerates smoothly. Next, move the playhead back to the start of the text layer and create an opacity keyframe, changing the value to 0. Move the playhead about 0.5 seconds forward and change the opacity value back to 100. Select these two keyframes and apply Ease In and Ease Out to them as well. Expand opacity and move the left and right handles closer to the middle, refining the fade in. This is already looking good, but to make it even better, let's duplicate the layer. I have 3 words in my text, so I'll duplicate the layer 2 times to get a total of 3 text layers. You can quickly duplicate a layer by holding the Alt key or Option key on Mac and dragging it to an empty track above. While the first layer is selected, go to Effect Controls and click on the Crop effect. You'll see handles appear in your program monitor. Use these handles to crop out only the first word. Then, select the second text layer, click the Crop effect, and crop to show only the second word. Repeat this process for the third text layer, cropping it to show only the third word. In the timeline, keep the first text layer at its original position. Move the second text layer 0.5 seconds forward, delay it slightly, and the third text layer another 0.5 seconds forward. This creates the staggered, smooth intro for our 3 words. Now for the second sentence and the outro animation. First, match the ending points of all 3 text layers on the timeline to the exact moment you want the text out animation to begin. Duplicate all 3 text layers again. Go into these duplicated layers and type your second sentence, ensuring you update the text on each of the 3 layers and readjust the crop for each new word. I'll fast forward through this part since we've already learned. Next, we need to nest each set of layers. Select the first set of 3 text layers and right-click to choose Nest. Do the same for the second set of 3 text layers. Let's create the ending transition for the first sentence. Go to the Effects panel and add the transform effect to the first nested layer. In the Effect Controls, under Transform, change the shutter angle to 360 again. Move the playhead near the end of the clip, about 1 second before the clip ends, and create a position keyframe. Move the playhead right to the very end and adjust the text to move slightly up. Select both keyframes and apply Ease In and Ease Out. Expand position and move left and right handles to middle like this. Go back to the first position keyframe and create an opacity keyframe with a value of 100. At the final position keyframe, change the opacity value to 0 to create the second keyframe. Apply ease in and ease out. Expand opacity and move the second handle all the way to the left to accelerate the fade out. Finally, copy this entire transform effect from the first nested layer. Select the second nested layer and press Ctrl plus V or Command plus V to paste it. Then, move the second nested layer into the ideal syncing position in your timeline. And that's it, and we are pretty much done. You've created a very simple, yet incredibly elegant and modern text animation. I hope you found this tutorial helpful. If you have any questions, comment below. I will reply as soon as possible. Thank you for watching. See you again in the next video.